Hi everyone. Let me start off by welcoming you to my new channel and thanking you for taking time out of your day to watch this video. So yesterday I talked a little bit about all the changes I made to my bike, and today I thought I would talk about ownership and riding. So when I decided that I wanted to get a new bike, I looked at pretty much everything available in my price range and that fit my specific criteria. I looked at BMW, Indian, Ducati, Triumph, even Harley. But when I found out Royal Enfield was not only coming back to America, but bringing us a revised new classic, I was very interested. And after seeing the specifications and pricing, I was hooked. I immediately contacted a local dealer who told me that good luck, and we have no idea when it's coming here. At that point, it was just a waiting game for it to arrive in America. Luckily, and much to my surprise, it was here within a year. And even more lucky, I was lucky enough to get one of the first ones right off the boat, and definitely one of the first red chromes, if not the first one. I couldn't be happier with my decision. It was definitely the right choice for me. While I've owned quite a few bikes over my 40 plus years of riding experience, I've reached the age now where I just wanted to buy a relaxed daily cruiser, and that's exactly what this is. Something that looks vintage but isn't. I can ride it all day and not have to worry if it's going to start the next morning. And if you've ever been in that position, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And don't think that you're getting a budget bike because of the budget price. It comes standard with ABS front and rear, metal mudguards, full toolkit, pretty much all the bells and whistles. It even has a built-in USB charger. And additionally, with the price of gas today, I've been averaging roughly 84 miles to a gallon, and on more than one occasion have reached as much as 95. So that in itself may be a reason to buy this bike if you're shopping. It's very comfortable, slightly less so with the low seat ride option that I chose, but still definitely one of the most comfortable bikes I've ever ridden or owned. And the weight is, it's definitely on the heavy side, but once you're riding, it's surprisingly nimble. And the new J-Series engine is a remarkable feat of accomplishment for Royal Enfield. I don't know all the changes they made, but whatever those changes were, it made a tremendous difference. If you've ever ridden an Enfield, you know how prone they are to vibration. These new bikes, almost zero vibration. I'm not exactly sure what they did, but magic. The changes I made, which I talked about yesterday, the mirrors, heel-toe shifter, the premium footboards, I would definitely suggest to any new owner of Royal Enfield, the mirrors especially, not only better looking, but it's very nice not to see your shoulders and to actually be able to see the traffic behind you. Having said all of that, I know that both of my first videos have been motorcycle related. It is not my intention to make this a motorcycle channel. Matter of fact, if I can reach 50 subscribers by November 16th, I plan on live streaming from behind the LA Auto Show. We'll see. Additionally, if you're interested in Los Angeles, photography, motorcycles, skateboarding, etc., I'd suggest you go check out my Instagram which is also at Levy Angelus, the same as my YouTube channel. And I think that's pretty much going to wrap it up. I know I'm getting towards the end of the video here, so this timed out pretty good. I'll just wrap up by saying that while this is underpowered and not very fast and on the heavy side, I'm very happy with my purchase. It does everything that I wanted and even more. The amazing gas mileage, as an example, that was a very nice surprise. Very comfortable and very nimble and not a lot of money. I mean, surprisingly cheap for what you're getting. I think the MSRP on the bike is something in the neighborhood of like $4,700, not including taxes and fees. I paid around $6,000 for mine and worth every penny, especially based on the other bikes I was looking at and what you would get for the money. The Triumph I was looking at was double the price, almost triple the price, actually, but definitely not triple the bike. And on that note, I'll just ask you to please give a thumbs up and subscribe.